Hey guys, welcome back to Code War. I'm Ramesh, and in this video, I'll explain how to draw an arc of a circle using graphics.h library. So first, let me explain you what do I mean by arc of a circle, and then I will explain how to draw it using graphics.h library. So let's start. An arc of a circle is a portion of the circumference of a circle. That means if we draw a circle and consider a small portion of its circumference, it is called an arc of a circle. So to draw an arc, we need the same properties that we require to draw a circle, that is the x and y coordinates of the center of the circle and its radius. But apart from these, we need two more properties of arc to draw it, which are start angle and end angle of arc. So you may ask, what is the meaning of these two? Actually, start angle is the angle at which we want to start drawing arc, and end angle is the angle up to which we want to draw the arc. These two angles are measured with respect to positive x-axis in counterclockwise direction. That means 3 o'clock represents 0 degree and 12 o'clock represents 90 degree. Okay, so now we know all about the properties required to draw an arc, but how to draw it using graphics.h library. So to draw an arc, graphics.h provides a function arc. It takes 5 integer arguments. The first two arguments are the x and y coordinates of the center of arc. Basically, this is the x and y coordinates of the center of the circle of which the arc is a portion. The third argument is the start angle. I've already explained about it. The fourth argument is the end angle, and the fifth argument is the radius of arc. Now let's implement it in code. Arc 320, 240, 45, 150, 200. Now build and run it. So here you can see this 320 and 240 represents the x and y coordinates of the center of arc. This 45 represents the starting angle of arc with respect to positive x-axis in counterclockwise direction. This 150 represents the ending angle of arc with respect to positive x-axis in counterclockwise direction. And finally, this 200 represents the radius of arc. Okay, now we know about arc function. Let's try to do some experiment with it to understand how it works and what we can do with it. Okay, so in this first experiment, I'm going to show you how the arc function behaves when we change either one of the angle. Let's create an animation. For integer I equals to 0, I less than 360, I plus plus, first we have to clear the graphics window, so write clear device. Now we have to draw arc, so write arc 320, 240. Okay, here I want to fix start angle to 0 degree and keep changing the end angle. So I am writing 0 for start angle and I for end angle. So the end angle will increase from 0 to less than 360. Now for radius of arc, I am giving 200. Now after drawing, we have to swap buffers. So write swap buffers. Finally, we have to delay our program's execution so we can see what has been drawn on a screen. So write delay 10. Okay, so in every iteration, our program will delay the execution for 10 milliseconds. Now our program is complete. Let's build and run it. Look at this. we have fixed the start angle to 0 degree and increasing the end angle. And here you can see it is increasing in counterclockwise direction. Let me run this again. Here we go. So I think you have got an idea about how the angle will affect the arc. Let's do some more experiments. Let me duplicate this. Okay, in this second experiment, we will keep the difference between start angle and end angle fixed, but in every iteration, we will keep changing the value of both angles. So first replace this start angle and end angle by minus I. This minus sign is to make sure the arc move in clockwise direction. Now both the start angle and end angle will change in every iteration, but right now we have to add a constant number in any one of these angles. So in this end angle, add any number between 1 to 360. I guess 80 will be good enough. By the way, I think we should run this loop 3 times more. Just multiply it by 3. Now let's build and run it. Here we go. You can see this arc is rotating. If we modify it to look good, then we can easily create a loading animation, right? But it is beyond the scope of this video. Let's move to the next experiment, and this will be the last one for this video. Okay, let's take it to the next level. This time we will move the start angle and end angle in opposite direction of each other. One more thing, this time we will have to make nested loop. I will explain it within a minute. For now, just write this. Let me comment this outer loop for now. Okay, fine. As I said, we will move the start angle and end angle in opposite direction. So write minus J for start angle and J for end angle. Now let me run this program to show you what this inner loop do. Okay, now I want it to repeat itself and rotate its starting point in every iteration. We will use the outer loop for this. Let's see how. So currently it will just repeat the animation, but we also want it to rotate itself in every iteration. So we will have to add I in both the angles for this. And now start angle will be I minus J and end angle will be I plus J. One more thing, we will have to increase the value of I with a bigger number, otherwise it will take long time to absorb the rotation. I'm increasing it by 30, but you can choose any number you want. So it is complete. Now let's build and run it. Here we go. You can see it is repeating itself, and also its starting point is being rotated in every iteration. Now you may ask, where can I use it? So for demonstration, if you have watched my Ludo game project, then let me know you that I have used the last two experiments in making the loading animation of my Ludo game. And I have also used the arc in designing its game board. You can also come up with your own ideas to use it. So guys, I think that's enough for this video. In the next video, I will explain about how to draw an ellipse using graphics.h library. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.